Hey, this is Flyguy back again with another Star Wars review. This time, it's a 3.75-inch Black Series figure. She's literally just over 3.75 inches in height. And she's absolutely tiny. It freaks me out every time I go back to reviewing 3.75 inch figures next to 6 inch. They're just so small. Wow. It's just, anyway... you forget how we get these so infrequently. Going back to these is a little weird in terms of size and scale. They just feel so small. It's just bizarre. We get some nice artwork on the package there of Jyn, and looks good. This is a brand new image we've not seen on any other packaging, as far as I can tell. Yes, it is indeed. And on the side of the package, we don't get any number. There are no numbering for these figures that are exclusive to Walmart in the US, etc. More text on the back if you want to freeze frame and read that. And for those that need to know it, there's the UPC. And up at the top, it's blank. And Sergeant Jyn Erso on the side. And that's the packaging. So this teeny, tiny, tiny figure is cool. It's nice to get Jyn in a 3.75 inch articulated scale. And she comes with a ridiculously big blaster that it feels like, but beautifully done blaster, I have to say. And we'll talk about that more in just a second. The figure itself, I think they've pretty much nailed the likeness of Jyn. It's a little hard to, she's so small, it's kind of hard to get this focused. But they've done a really good job of this. Some weathering and sculpting going on, nice little folds on the details there of the side of the figure. It's pretty good looking. She's even got a working holster. Little wrinkles in the fabric down at the boots. It's a good looking figure, even all the kind of little cushioned parts on the back of her waistcoat. So they're giving 3.75 in some love, albeit very sporadically and not that often. But I think in terms of the sculpt, they've pretty much nailed that. That's Felicity Jones. They've done a good job. Managed to get the hair sculpted nicely. That's a very good, very detailed 3.75 inch figure. And with a little bit of silver and detail up at the kind of little pouches and a zip or whatever that may be. And even a little gloved hands and fingers. They've done a good job. They've done a very good job here. Now, look, we'll come back to the articulation in a minute, but this blaster is a work of art. It really is. Now, for once, rather than a piece of black plastic, a solid black plastic, we're getting some really interesting stuff going on here. This is a three-part piece that all clips together. And then each part is a kind of grey gunmetal plus silver. And a little bit of black almost in parts of it, and it makes for a very interesting, very realistic looking weapon, and I'm super impressed by this. I know you're probably just thinking what a sad sack I am, but this is a lot of work for something that is literally, I mean, 1 inch, two inches tall. I mean, that's a lot of work and effort that's gone into this thing. So what it does is split into three parts. We've got the butt piece that clips on the back there, and this is a little pin here, and I don't see anywhere on Felicity that this can pin into, so I'm not quite sure what that little piece is there designed to do, or I don't know, maybe it can reclip in, you can get a fourth way, I don't know. If somebody knows, please let me know what this little pin is down at the bottom. I may be wrong. It also then splits off into a little pistol that she has, and then into this rifle scope part that we see there. Now, sadly, she doesn't get to display any of this stuff or hold it on her person in any way, so you just got to leave them on the floor, I guess, and you've got her pistol, which can then slot into that little weapon holster there, and there you go. So it's not a bad looking little piece there going on. But yeah, she can't carry the other items, and there doesn't appear to be any little peg holes or any other way on her thigh or anywhere that she could have put these other pieces there. So a little bit of a letdown on that aspect, but still, great looking weapon. 10 out of 10 has, but what a great job they've done at that scale and that size. It's pretty amazing. So for articulation on this little figure, you've got a ball jointed head, and that just rotates around. Full movement, no real, I mean, chicken can't really move forward or back. It's kind of limited. That's as much as you'll get. You've got full articulation on the arm, so they will swivel all the way around. No limit to this waist jacket comes off. You get articulation at the elbows, single joint at the elbows, so you get plenty of movement going on there. You've got swivel wrists, and there's no other movement on the wrist. She is, being a female figure, the size and scale of it, they haven't gone for anything else there, I think. Nope. Which is understandable, I think, at that scale and size. Upper torso has a crunch too, so there's a fair range of movement that goes on there. Up at the tops of the thighs, you can see there's a little slot or a groove. Don't be dirty now. There's the groove there. So that allows for that hinge to move the legs in just about any position you want. You've also got a swivel thigh up at the top. and you get a single joint down at the knees. Actually, pretty good, nearly more than 45 degrees out there, and down to the rocking ankles. A little bit limited and restricted down there, but you can get them to move. A little bit of the paint's got into the groove there. And of course, peg holes for those things Hasbro never give us. So you've got really quite a good range of movement. You've got an excellent looking figure. This is one I'm sure a lot of 3.75 fans will buy. I'm just continuing to buy these because there's articulation on them, and I'm a bit of a sucker for the Black Series, so I'm going to keep going and review all of these. We've got the Death Trooper and others to come. But a good looking figure. I'll put a link directly as usual in the description. Go buy it if you can get it, if you're lucky enough to find one in the US. Otherwise, RobotKingdom.com is about the only other place that I know globally that is selling these. And yes, they're not fakes if they're outside the US, guys, in the US. So a lot of people keep saying figures are fake if they're not sold in Walmarts. That is not true. Yes, these things are made in China and Vietnam. So, yes, they are available in other countries. But as of this moment, it's literally only three countries in the world that are selling these. Big W is the store in Australia that's selling them. Asda in the UK is the official other place to sell them. And, of course, in the US, Walmart. So that's the one that everybody knows. So, yes, that's where you can get them. And if not, again, link in the description below. If you're brand new to the channel, click subscribe and let us know what you think of this figure. Give it a thumbs up, thumbs down, share it. And we will see you for some more figure reviews coming up soon.